तुझको या तेरे नदीश गिरिवन को नमन करूं मैं, किसको नमन करूं मैं भारत, किसको नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं मैं, नमन करूं।
One of the simplest possible solutions to contain air pollution is to increase the tree cover. The leaves of trees absorb the carbon dioxide in the air and convert it into organic food molecules using the energy of sunlight. In this process, plants reduce the carbon dioxide content in the atmosphere and release in exchange oxygen, much needed for the survival of all living things.
The leaves and bark absorb harmful pollutants and release clean oxygen for us to breathe. In urban environments, trees absorb pollutant gases like nitrogen oxides, ozone, and carbon monoxide, and also trees like Indian rosewood, Indian blackberry, etc., sweep up particles like dust and smoke. Sitting under these trees only, in ancient times, the great seers and saints had compiled the text of Brahmanas, Aranyakas, and Upanishads. While in the forest of Dandak, Lord Ram felt great delight under the shade of five trees, which are banyan, fig, wood apple, Indian gooseberry, and Ashoka. The birth of Gautam Buddha was under a tree, and moreover, he attained enlightenment also under a tree only. Even the melodious musical flute tunes of the ever sportive Shri Krishna also echoed under the trees. It is rather unfortunate that the so-called civilized and development-oriented humans prefer to light the lamps of peace and happiness staying in air-conditioned buildings built by cutting off trees. Alas, is it possible?
It appears that humans, charged with the zeal of their great wisdom, have committed the folly of considering plants as insentient objects. One can find plants described as sentient but immovable forms in Vedas, scriptures, and Upanishads. Prananti viruddha and jivantim aushadhim are the Vedic proclamations which prove this. Not only that, a contemplation of this has been thought of as an insult by humans, but they have also refused to accept the experimentally proven contention of our early scientist Dr. Jagdish Chandra Basu of plants having life. That is why humans have no remorse in their heart while axing trees.
In one big room at London, many leading scientists of the world are seated. Shri Jagdish Chandra Basu is also seen amongst them.
Dear friends, after conducting many experiments and indulging in deep thinking, I have come to the conclusion that there is life even in trees and plants. To sustain themselves and to keep themselves alive, they also need air, water, light.
How can it ever be possible? How could we ever accept what you're saying is correct?
As a proof of my belief, now I'm going to immerse the roots of this plant in a poisonous solution. If this plant shrivels up, understand that it has life in it.
Dipping the roots in the solution, Dr. Basu keeps looking at the plant for some time. Seeing no change in the plant, all scientists start laughing sarcastically. Boldly, Dr. Basu looks at them and says with confidence,
I am fully confident that this poisonous fluid is fake. It is definite that pure poison was not allowed to reach me. I can prove it just now.
Saying this, he drinks the fake poison. all scientists look at him quietly. Dr. Basu waits for some time to allow the poison to take effect. After that, smilingly he says,
I'm sure that all of you have witnessed with your own eyes. Has this not been a fake poison, I would have been dead by now. With that, I shall prove that even plants and trees have life in them.
New sample of poison is brought. Dr. Basu dips the roots of the plant in the poisonous solution. By the use of a crescograph, Dr. Basu proves that plants also have life. All the scientists clap in appreciation of the demonstration of Dr. Basu. The consciousness of trees and plants are so much under the influence of the attribute of dullness that their mind and intellect are in a state of quiescence or dormant. Only the food and life force or vital energy sheaths alone are developed in them. Others are not developed. It is because of this the plants and trees do not feel the type of pain that the animals feel when they are slaughtered.
This is the reason why the Supreme Lord has created plants as food for all animals and humans. In the absence of plants, neither would we have had oxygen to breathe nor food to eat. Trees or plants in a 100 by 100 square meter land will consume 800 kg of carbon dioxide and release 600 kg of oxygen every day.
But alas, modern humans have become so thankless. They do not feel any remorse in cutting trees heartlessly under the influence of monetary greed. They do not think even for a minute as to how would they survive if the trees that sustain them are not there. They do not forget that the basis of most of the drugs, industry and business is vegetation. The culture of India proclaims loudly that Das Putra Samodrumaha, meaning one tree is equal to 10 sons. It is unfortunate that Indians also, like people of other countries, express their cruelness in cutting trees.
Indian literature has always reported a deep and intense inner connection with trees. The following is a description of the composition of the unique poet Kalidas, an exponent of simile and metaphor, in the words of Kumar Sambhav. Once, a wild elephant, to get relief from itchiness, was rubbing its cheek against a cedar tree, which was protected by Lord Shiva and nurtured by Goddess Parvati, just like her son Skand was nurtured by her milk. When the bark of the tree got peeled out by the hard rubbing of the elephant, Goddess Parvati's heart got distressed seeing it, just as she got distressed by seeing her son Skand's body being pierced by the arrow shot by demons.
The hermitage of Maharshi Kanva. Cows are grazing. Shakuntala is seen watering the trees of the hermitage from a pot. As she is watering, her friend Anasuya comes.
How long will you keep watering the plants?
Just a few more plants are left to be watered.
I feel the seer loves these plants more than you.
Why do you say like that?
Shakuntala, your body is more delicate than these plants. Even then, why have the seer given you this hard task to carry out?
I love these plants more like my brothers. It is my duty to take care of them with a sense of utmost love. I am performing this task self-willingly.
You consider even these plants as your brothers? Shakuntala, blessed you are.
These trees were planted by the celibate disciples of Maharishi.
Blessed is our culture where we consider the plants and trees that are born by Mother Earth as our sons and brothers and nurture them with love and tenderness. Will the descendants of Lord Macaulay ever try to grasp even a bit of these ideals? A famous saint of Maharashtra, Namdev, once in his childhood had gone to fetch the bark of a medicinal tree that was wanted by his mother. The moment he strikes it with his axe, the sap of the tree started flowing out. He felt as if he had struck a human with the axe and his blood was flowing out. He was so moved by this that he developed intense detachment and relinquished his worldly life. Those who understood the importance of the green trees have sacrificed their life in the cause of their protection. In the year 1730, the sacrifice rendered by 363 people of the Bishnoi community of Khijri village of Rajasthan will be written forever in golden words in the history of environmental protection.
The assembly of King Ajit Singh of Jodhpur is in session, seated on either side in rows in front of the king can be seen the prime minister, commander of the army and other counselors.
There is a wish in my mind to build a huge palace, but...
But what, your honor? Your command alone is paramount to us. We are ever committed to fulfill your wish.
To make a place in this desert area, tell me, from where will you bring the necessary wood?
In our state, there's a village of Bishnois called Khijri. In that village, there are huge sponge trees. But there is a problem.
What type of problem?
The members of Bishnoi community consider Saint Jamboji as their spiritual master. He has given the teaching to his followers to consider. Because of this, cutting the trees will not be easy.
O King, this is my job. Please give the order. I shall go with my army and the task shall be executed easily.
Okay, then go with your army and bring the cut trees.
Who are these people? Hope their evil eyes are not on the trees. I should reach there immediately. Seeing so many soldiers of the king here today, some serious doubt is arising in my mind. I am going there. You please remain here only.
No, mother. We will also come with you.
Cut down all these trees quickly.
Who has given you permission to cut these trees?
The king is building a castle for which there is a need for wood. On his order only, we have come to cut the trees.
We have looked after these trees like our sons. You cannot even touch these trees as long as I am alive.
Oh, worthy lady, I shall get the price of these trees from the royal treasury. So allow me to follow the royal order.
O commander of the army, for sake of money are you prepared to submit your sons to death? What we have learned from our spiritual master is that the trees are also like our sons. So at any cost, I am not going to allow you to cut the trees.
Hey soldiers, what are you waiting for? Pick up your axes and start cutting the trees. If anyone tries to stop, cut them also.
This valorous land of warriors is ashamed that it has given birth to a disgraceful son like you for ordering to cut the trees as well as us. I shall gladly embrace death but would not allow to cut even a single tree.
The soldiers keep cutting trees along with people. The commander keeps watching the blood flow with disgust.
O King, your honor. So far, we have not been able to cut even a single tree fully. Hundreds of villagers are ready to sacrifice themselves to save the trees. So far, 363 people have already laid down their lives. The commander wants to know from you, what should we do?
Go there quickly and tell the commander to return with his soldiers. Prime Minister? Today I have committed a grave blunder. As long as this earth, sun and moon are in existence, my name will ever remain disgraced in history for having killed my innocent sons like subjects for my comfort and pleasure. Those 363 Bishnois have sacrificed their lives for protecting the trees as though their sons. It is indeed unfortunate that I have failed, disgraced my royal duty. In the history of future, I shall never be forgiven for this wicked act.
The revelations of Sri Prannathji, known as Tartamvani, describes the divine beauty of trees in such loving words.
Amba ambalione aso pala अंजीर ने अखोड़ अन्नास ने आंबलियों दिसे चारोले चंपा छोड़ साग सिसम ने सेमला सरगो सरस ने सुपारी सूफ सुकड़ ने साजड़िया अगर ऊंचो अति भारी अगर ऊंचो अति भारी वड़ पीपल ने बांस वेकला बोल सरी ने वरणा जी केवड़ केल कपूर कसुंगो केसर झाड़ अति घड़ा जी अति घड़ा जी अति घड़ा जी।
In 1930, there was strong protest against the forest exploitation policy of the British government. Farmers staged a protest demonstration at a vast ground in the town of Tiladi in Himachal Pradesh. Chakradhar Juyal, minister of Tihari, got the unarmed farmers gunned down through his soldiers. Many farmers got killed while quite a few got drowned in Yamuna. The supreme sacrifice made by these farmers towards protection of forest will be remembered by the world forever. People who cut trees to satisfy their monetary greed should try to listen to their tender cries.
देने की चाहली
1974, the Forest Department had declared an auction for cutting 2,500 trees in the Raini village of Uttarakhand. Gaura Devi of that village, along with 21 other women, objected to this and stayed put, hugging the trees, declaring that as long as they are alive, they would not allow to cut the trees. The forest authorities had to ultimately yield to the firm determination of the woman. This incident led to the Chipko movement under the leadership of Sundarlal Bahuguna and Chandi Prasad Bhatt and others. Similar movement also took shape in Karnataka in 1983 under the name of Apiko movement. It essentially means embracing trees. Both men and women and even children had taken part in this movement, and they went and embraced the trees. In the wake of their firm determination, the forest department had to bow down. Humans project themselves as modern, cultured, and progressive by cutting trees. Had such humans ever been a bit sensitive to the dumb cries of the trees, they would have definitely shed a few tears of compassion from their eyes. Oh humans, you are the most special creation of this universe. Are you not wise enough to the fact that in service to you, I remove through my leaves all the poisonous gases and provide you with pure air needed for your survival? Even if you throw stones at me, I give you sweet fruits. In the mid-noon of summer months, I burn myself, but I give you cool shade and all the time strive to keep the air as cool as possible so that you don't suffer the discomfort of heat. Every year, I make compost for you, shedding all my leaves so that you can produce more and more grain for you. I know it very well that when my soul would leave my decrepit body and get dried up, every part of my body will be useful to you for cooking food, building houses, and for many other things. But I'm still fully green and in my youth. Please don't cut me with your axe. I wish that I live for some more time in this world under the blue sky, so that I can keep giving you clean air and keep feeding you with sweeter and sweeter fruits. And by seeing you smiling, I may also keep smiling and feel myself blessed.
Ideally, for a healthy environment, it is essential to have 33% and 66% forests in the plain and hilly areas respectively. Absence of trees increases the aerial content of poisonous gases, dust and ash, which make our minds to shudder thinking of the dangerous consequences.
Carbon monoxide is known to cause suffocation, while sulfur dioxide causes problems of respiratory tract and even damage the lungs. Nitric oxide also causes harm to the lungs and lead to cancer development. Carbon dioxide contributes maximally to atmospheric heating. In addition, gases like CFC, methane, and chlorine, etc., are responsible for many diseases. Particles of glass, cadmium, benzene, radioactive material, dust, and ash cause many grievous diseases.
There are 33 major rivers in India whose combined length is of about 22,579 kilometers. When they get flooded during the monsoon season, they assume a macabre or frightening appearance. These rivers, which keep the earth green by their elixir form of water, cause much havoc, resulting in the loss of crores of rupees when they assume the posture of violent dance.
The solution to the problem of floods is also with the trees. If bamboo trees are planted 20 meters apart on either side of the river, it would not only bind the soil together and prevent the occurrence of floods, but also help economically. Between the bamboo trees, deep-rooted fruit-bearing trees or Indian damar, rosewood and teakwood trees of great timber value should be planted. If bamboo trees are planted on hilly areas, it would check soil erosion or landslide and also reduce the accumulation of slate in the rivers. By deepening the rivers in the summer season, plying of steamers and boats can be made possible. This can contribute to increased trade activities.
In recent times, the whole world is stricken with increasing desertification. Increasing deforestation is contributing to global warming and drought, because of which roughly about 23 hectares of land is getting transformed into desert every minute. The process of desertification from ancient times has made many civilizations its victim. If the process of desertification is not stopped, the world will have to face grave consequences, as the world population is expected to be 10 billion by 2050. On the other hand, by that time, 360 hectares of land will become uncultivable, which could have produced about 600 lakh tons of food grain.
The area of Thar Desert in Rajasthan is about 2,59 square kilometer. It is encroaching into Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh at the rate of half a kilometer every year. To stop the spread of flying sand and prevent the invasion of desert, a broad strip on the periphery planted with oriental thuja and trees like Indian rosewood and Indian blackberry would be very useful. In this respect, Israel is an ideal country worth emulating, as it has converted vast barren lands into verdant land with its firm determination and application of modern techniques.
To convert desert into verdant land, bush morning glory tree should be planted in the monsoon season 25 meters apart. In between, creation of many small artificial ponds should also be considered. It should be followed by planting of gum arabic tree in the second year and planting of Indian gooseberry trees in the third year. While planting Indian gooseberry plants, it should be ensured that some loam soil is put below their roots and also arranged for availability of water for a few months. In areas where there is a probability of forming sand hills, a hedge of prickly pears should be erected. The Indian gooseberry trees have great ability of bringing rains. Even during dry weather, if we stand below the Indian gooseberry tree, it would feel as though a cool drop of water has fallen on us.
A tree named Paradise Tree or Bitterwood Tree is available at the organization of Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, which can be easily grown even in barren and infertile lands. Its botanical name is Cimarruba glauca. 1 hectare of this plant can provide 20 quintals of cooking oil, 40 quintals of fruit, and 80 quintals of fodder. This tree is also useful in making phytomedicines against diseases like cancer. This tree can definitely convert barren, infertile, and even desert lands into verdant lands, and could prove very useful from environmental and economic points of view.
Mountainous areas in the monsoon season, it can be easily seen how the trees attract the clouds and make them rain. In dry, parched areas, trees like margosa and the Indian gooseberry can easily help bring rain. Social foresting with the Indian gooseberry tree can greatly rejuvenate the entire Rajasthan.
In a village called Piplantri in the city of Rajasmand in Rajasthan, a tradition of planting 51 trees has been established whenever a girl child is born. When the girl attains marriageable age, entire expenses of marriage are met by the trees. Today, the village of Piplantri has developed as an ecotourism center. Alas, think how great it would have been if all the villages of India had such a tradition. In India, the role of the Himalaya, forest, and fire offering of clarified butter is great in bringing rain. King of Lanka, Ravan, had got planted Ashoka tree all around his palace, extending to many kilometers, because of which there was rain all around the year despite being close to the equator. Scientists of the day can take motivation from this and provide cool breeze to the world scorching under the hot sun.
The current population of India is about 1.3 billion. If every Indian citizen would plant one tree every year for 10 consecutive years, the number of trees can touch 13 billion, which bring revolution in the control of air pollution. It would be a great act if every individual in our villages would plant trees like neem, Indian gooseberry, or Ashoka in front of the house or in the fields on events like birth, marriage, or other auspicious occasions. Growing Ashoka tree in front of every house was a tradition in ancient India. Knowing the medicinal importance of Ashoka tree for females only, Ravan had kept Sita captive in the Ashoka forest.
Professor T.M. Das of Calcutta University had firmly established that a tree of 50 years can benefit human being to the tune of about 15.7 lakhs either directly or indirectly. Because of this only, Vedas have forbidden cutting of green trees. Kakambhiram Vanaspatim Ma Udvriha.
Sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramaya, 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 sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchit dukh bhag bhavet, ma kashchit dukh bhag bhavet, ma kashchit dukh bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti.